loves. So today we're gonna do a little makeup collection video, but I thought I would first give you a little overview of my room. I did a beauty room tour, but my room is a little bit different. I'm constantly rearranging, it's just what I do. So I'm gonna show you guys all of the makeup that I have on my computer desk, everything that's over here. This is like my pride and joy right there. That houses mostly eyeshadow palettes. Then I have some makeup up here. Of course, on my vanity, there's a bunch of makeup here. And then when we turn around, oh, don't look out there, it's a mess. But, okay, focus, you can do it. There we go. There's a bunch of makeup on this bookshelf. So we're gonna go through our thing. Does that make you dizzy when I spin like that? I'm sorry. But yeah, let's get started. Let me tell you guys about my chair. I'm gonna talk about this in my January favorites. This was sent to me by the brand. Wait, let me pull it out so I can show you guys. This is from the brand RapidX. I had never heard of this brand. They contacted me. They said, we would like to send you a chair. And of course I was like, okay. This freaking chair is so badass. I think it's a gaming chair, but it's so cool. Like, it's so comfortable. It reclines. It's like changed my life. I know that sounds so silly. This video is not sponsored. They're not paying me. I don't make a penny off of it. The chair is very expensive. But if you need, like, if you're a gamer and you need a badass chair, I will put their link down below if anybody's interested. It is cool. Okay, let's start over here on my computer desk. I was watching CSI. So I have this little spinner guy that, where is this from? Does it say on here where it's from? This is either like Original Beauty Box or Sunny Cosmetics. I will find it and I'll put it down below. But I have all of my Makeup Forever Artist Rouge lippies in here. Then I just have some brushes and I need to fill it up. I just have two Physicians Formula. Two Physicians Formula powders in there. And then this little thing. This is a little mirror that was made for me by one of my subscribers, and I love it. So I just keep it here so I can see it. And then I have some Buxom lip glosses. They were from a holiday set, I think, last Christmas. And that's all the makeup for my computer desk. And my desk is from Ikea. Computer is iMac. I don't really have much makeup back here. I have some brushes. This brush was sent to me from my aunt for Christmas. This is that Wayne Goss brush that is like way expensive, but I don't use it. I just keep it there as decoration because it's so beautiful and I know she paid a pretty penny for it. Okay, so I'm gonna do a voiceover for pretty much the rest of the video just because it was easier with me filming. So we're gonna go through my big acrylic organizer that I got at Home Goods. So everything that's on top of there is usually not there. I'm going through my single eyeshadows right now, which is what is in that NARS palette that I just pointed at. So in this top drawer, I have this Buxom palette that was given to me from my friend Erin. She loved it, but she said she wasn't using it a lot. It is amazing. It's called Dolly's Wild Side. Then I have this Catrice palette that they sent me. These are just shadows that I need to start using. So there's a Laura Geller palette, this little NARS single. Throughout this video, you're gonna see me struggle trying to open stuff with one hand. Gorgeous, NARS duos are amazing. Then this NYX Ultimate palette is really good. And then I have this Tarte Z palette that, what do I have in there? I totally forget. Let's open it up and find out. Oh, those are Makeup Forever singles. Yes, they kind of look like the Morphe premium ones. I had to think about it. Next drawer is my Urban Decay Naked Basics. And then I have two of my Juvia's Place palettes. This one is the Masquerade Mini, which is amazing. And then the Nubian 2 is my favorite. The quality is outstanding. I have a code for Juvia. I will put it down below. And then my little Jouer Essential palette. And this palette is from Luxie Beauty. That does them no justice. They are stunning. They're duochromes and they are so pretty. So moving on to drawer numero uno, dos, tres. I know my Spanish. So these are blushes. So I have my NARS Unfiltered 1 and 2 palettes. Oh, I was looking a hot mess when I filmed this. And then I have my MAC Contour Your Life palette. I always forget what it's called, but it's my favorite. Then my Benefit Cheekathon palette, which I grab for all the time. I love Dandelion. I love Hoola. I pretty much love everything that's in that palette. And I also have another Tarte Z palette. I love these Tarte palettes. And inside I have my Tarte, not eyeshadows, Tarte blushes that I depotted and one Illamasqua blush. Next drawer, I have my Morphe Kathleen Lights palette, my Violet Voss and Laura Lee, and the Violet Voss Holy Grail palette. And then, oh, I'm showing you guys the Laura Lee palette. It's amazing. Their Violet Voss eyeshadows are stunning. And then the Makeup Geek highlighters that I don't grab for every day, I just have in the back. And then I have some Jouer eyeshadows that I use quite a bit. The Moonchild palette from Anastasia. And that is it. Next drawer, this drawer I love. So I have the NYX Perfect Filter palette, which I really love. My Natasha Denona palette, which I, oh my God, the quality is just on another level. And then the two newest Morphe palettes, which I've been testing out. I feel like they look very similar, but they're both really good. I don't know if I open one or not. Nope, guess I don't. Then I have my After Dark palette from Urban Decay, which look at that packaging. It's so pretty. And this, the Colored Rain Queen of Hearts palette. Oh my God, you guys, this is limited edition, I think. You need it. It is so good. Seriously, everyone should own it. It is amazing. Next drawer is probably my favorite. These are like my favorite shadows at the moment. So my Modern Renaissance palette from ABH, which is just my favorite palette. But the Queen of Hearts is giving her a run for her money. And then the Mario palette, my Natasha Denona Star palette. We have the Persona palette, which is from Sona Gasparian on YouTube, I mean on Instagram, which is also really good. My little Maneater palette, which is so cute. And then I have my Viseart eyeshadows. This one was gifted to me from Violet, my little Violet. And then I have two matte ones. The one on the right is the newest one. They are incredible. The quality is crazy. And then I have my Tartist Pro palette. And in the back, I have my little, oh, we're going to talk about this little Viseart guy. This is the Petite Pro palette. It's so cute. It's like the size of a credit card. And you can take them out. They're just magnetic. They just like pop right out if you want to put them in a Z palette. I love this little thing. Quality is just crazy. Viseart shadows are incredible. And then I have my Tarte Lid in Bloom, which you guys know I love. And then I have the Itsy Coffee Break with Dani singles in the back there that I've been testing out. So that is it for that drawer. Now let's watch me fumble to try to put everything away. So that's it for my big acrylic organizer. I love this thing so much. If I could find another one, I would be so thrilled. Now we're moving over to my Alex drawers. So on top, I just have my ColourPop lip liners. I have some setting sprays. And then I have this palette holder, which is from, I want to say by Allegory. I will have a lot of information down below. So I just have a bunch of palettes in it that I grab for a lot. So a bunch of Too Faced palettes, the Lorac Pro palettes, my two Kat Von D Monarch and Chrysalis, which you can no longer get, but I love them. Naked 3, I think I have all of my Naked palettes in here. And then just some of the little Too Faced tins and my La Mer loose powder. And then I have all of my ColourPop lippy sticks. So I have the dark ones in the back, the nude ones in the middle, and then in the front, that's just overflow because we are running out of room. Then I have some beauty blenders and my Makeup Geek Iconic lips. These I really like. I didn't care for the plush ones, but these were really good. And then I have my little lipstick spinny tower, which is from Zara Beauty. And I just have an assortment in here. So I have some CoverGirl, Tom Ford, Chanel, Charlotte Tilbury, Urban Decay, H&M, NARS, more Urban Decay, Jordana, Modern Mats. There's some e.l.f. on the bottom. And then up top, I have my favorite Jouer lip creams. So that's it for the top, I think. Oh, I had to show you my little sample of Josie Maran Vibrancy Foundation, which I need to try out. That is it for the top. Now moving in to the drawers. Top drawer is all foundation. So I just got these Pure Barrett All Foundations, which I just put in this little Smashbox container. So on the right side, I have some powder foundations, which I don't use very often, but I still like to have them on hand. And then I have my Makeup Forever HD Stick Foundations, this Alginist one that Erin gave me that I have yet to try. EX1, some Rimmel, some Bourjois, more Rimmel, Matte and Poreless, which I love, Smashbox Studio Skin, which I also love. There's some L'Oreal Pro Glow, and then in the back, there's mostly Too Faced Born This Way, which is my favorite, all-time favorite foundation. There's also some Rimmel, some of the Makeup Forever HD. Is that the Ultra HD? I think I still have some of the old HD, which I really like. And then my One Heck of a Blot from Soap and Glory. And I'm running out of breath, but that, my friends, is my top drawer. I'm gonna catch my breath. Drawer number two. These are mostly concealers. It's kind of a little bit of everything. On the right side, I have some cream highlighters. So the ones from Pure Cosmetics, which I don't use a ton, but I do still grab for them. They're really, really nice. And I also have my flash palette over here from Makeup Forever and my Makeup Forever cream contour palette, which is amazing. If you're into cream contouring, you need this. It's really good. And I'm just going to show you that for a good 5 to 10 minutes. Oh, my flash palette. I only use it at Halloween, but I still keep it in there. And then I just have some pot concealers. I have some of the Becca correctors. So I have the really red one, the peachy one. I think I have all of them. And I'm, of course, struggling to do things with one hand. It's really hard to do things with one hand, you guys. And then a little erase paste from Benefit. And then I'm just going to give you a little close-up of all of my concealers. I know this is a sin. And this is decluttered. This is after I went through it. So there's just everything. Like, you name it, it's probably in there. I have a concealer addiction, and I'm totally okay with that. I mean, I use pretty much my Urban Decay Naked Skin every single day of my life. But hey, a bitch needs to have options. So yeah, there's some Tarte, It Cosmetics, NYX, Too Faced, LA Girl, Urban Decay, Smashbox, Maybelline, NARS, Rimmel. Good Lord, Nicole, you have a problem. Then moving to the back, I have some BB cream. So I have the NARS Velvet Skin, which isn't really a BB cream, but I keep it in there. I have the Urban Decay One and Done, which I really like in the summertime. Some LA Girl. The LA Girl BB cream is really nice. Then in this next little compartment, and these little clear organizers I get from Target in the kitchen section. I love them. Oh, shit. No, Erin. Oh my God, I'm so sorry. Okay, then I have liquid highlighters. This Josie Maran one is my all-time favorite liquid illuminizer. It's so intense and beautiful. Oh my God, it's so pretty. I have the Revlon Skin Lights. In the back, there are the Cover FX, the highlighting drops, which everybody went crazy for last year. This next drawer, I have some NARS cream blushes, cream bronzers, again, fumbling with the one hand. I think this one is Hot Sand. It's really, really pretty. And then I have a bunch of the Maybelline ones, the little strobing sticks and the highlighting sticks. There's some Wet n Wild in there. There's the Glossier one on the bottom. So again, just a total assortment of everything, but mostly NARS. And then the next drawer is primers. So I have my favorite NARS Hot Sand. I love to mix this with foundation. It looks so pretty. This little e.l.f. stick, which I've been trying out, I don't think that I love it. The Chanel Le Blanc de Chanel, which is amazing if you have dry skin. And then I have my little strobe cream from MAC, which I love so much. Even though I have oily skin, it's one of my favorites. And my Murad Oil Control Mattifier, which I use in the summertime. And yeah, that's it for drawer number two. I know. I'm a junkie. You guys, don't judge me. It's my collection. Next drawer is blushes, powders, and some bronzers. So again, it's just a little bit of everything. So there's some Quo, some Milani. I have a Charlotte Tilbury. Gosh. Wet n Wild on the bottom. That Wet n Wild one is actually really good. There's Makeup Forever in the back, and then this By Terry one, which I struggled for 20 minutes to open, and I could not get it, so I just totally took the footage out. These were limited edition Maybelline ones. Essence, the Blush Ups, which are really pretty. They're very, very, faint. You have to build them up, but they are very pretty. More Quo, some limited edition Revlon ones from, 2 years ago. I should probably get rid of them, but I'm not going to. Rimmel, NYX, there's a Josie Maran Coconut gelée something or other in there. Then onto powders, I have some NYX, Rimmel. I like the Rimmel Stay Matte. That one's really nice. I have some Soap and Glory, a few little Girlactic ones. The Bourjois Healthy Balance powders are amazing. My aunt sends me them from Canada. So good. The Kick-Ass powder from Soap and Glory, not the biggest fan of, and One Heck of a Blot, same thing. I feel like they're a little bit heavy, but I still keep them because I think maybe one day I'll fall in love. Then my MAC MSF in Medium Dark, which I use in the summertime. Love this powder. Really, really, really good powder. And then there's a Hello Flawless from Benefit, which I have a few shades of. They had sent it to me, so this one is more of a summer shade. And then my banana powder from Ben Nye and an e.l.f. body glow. So in this drawer, this whole Alex setup, these are products that I don't grab for every day. My vanity tour will be in part two. Then in this little guy, I have bronzing powders. So there's some NARS. There's some Becca. This one, again, is a summer shade. I forget the name of this one. I'll have to put it up on the screen for you guys. It's really, really dark for my skin tone, so it only works for me in the summer. And then some Makeup Forever, the MAC Selena one, which I was really excited about, and it was sent to me. But I don't know, I didn't love it, but I'm still going to keep it because it's like a collector's item, of course. And then I have some Too Faced and some Lise Wattier. I don't know if that's how you say it, but I feel so fancy when I say that. There's an e.l.f. bronzer palette. There is some Benefit Hoola. That's like a little backup one. And then there is a Guerlain, which is a little bit too orange toned for me, so I don't really wear that one. I have a lighter one that I like better. And in the back, I have a few NARS like blush duos. This one's actually really pretty. So I go into this drawer every now and then and I kind of like swap products out. So these are just like products, like I said, that I don't use every single day. And then I have the Becca powders that they came out with recently that everybody like went crazy over. Oh, I had to show you guys Benefit Hervana. I don't think you can get this anymore. It's so pretty and I love it. I will never get rid of it. I used to rock it like it was going out of style. These little Becca powders. I'll put the name on the screen, what they're called, but I didn't really care for them. And then I have this Mally Duo, which was sent to me by the brand. And the one side is a cream. The blush is really nice, but the cream I don't really care for, so I don't really use it that much. Then there are some Girard highlighters and the LA Girl strobing powders, which I do really like. These are the shades that I don't grab for a lot. I have some other ones in my vanity for like every day. So that is my powder drawer. Next drawer is more blushes and bronzers. So I have big products on the right, like things that pretty much don't fit anywhere else. So a Coty Airspun, NYC Smooth Skin, my favorite Milani, Tantastic. I love that thing in the summertime. There's a flower powder, It Cosmetics, then all of my ColourPop blushes, highlighters, and bronzers. I kind of just have them all mixed together. I love ColourPop's blushes. Don't really care for the bronzers as much, but the highlighters and the blushes are amazing. So I keep those guys in there, and then on the left side of the drawer, like in the back, you can see I have an extra Wet n Wild contouring palette. There's some e.l.f. palettes back there, and I just have some more highlighters. So there's an Ofra one, Wet n Wild, Maybelline. There's some Love Luxe Beauty, my favorite Physicians Formula one I keep in there, Quo. I see some Laura Geller in there. Yeah, just a little bit of earthing. Oh my gosh. My mom just texted me the funniest picture. Mom, I can't look at my phone when I'm doing voiceovers. It just doesn't work. So this is a Beauty Bar Baby, like loose powder that I use occasionally. More Becca. Oh, and then the Estee Lauder Bronze Goddess. I purchased this like a year ago. I was so excited about it. But when I got it home, I was just like, oh, really? That's it? Like, it just doesn't have much of, like, a bling to it, but it's so pretty. Like, to look at it in the pan, it's gorgeous. So that is that. I know I have way too much of everything, But it's my job, yo. It's my job, yo. Catch me outside. How about that? Next drawer, I love this drawer. Look how pretty it is when you open it up. Ah, just love it. So these are all just compacts. So on the left side, I have bigger compacts. So like my Becca highlighters, there's some Becca blushes, like duos in there, the Jaclyn Hill champagne splits. And then in the front of the second row, that's all Soap and Glory. There's some Balm, some Girlactic, some MAC. There's the Girl On one that I use a lot more in the center there. I wish I could like point to it and show you guys. These ones in the front are MAC limited edition from a few years ago. Then I have some NARS by Terry. Oh, I'm going to show you one of the Becca ones. I just randomly grabbed one and I chose the like hottest pink ever. The struggle bus is in full effect. Ooh, baby, look at that. It's really pretty though if you use it very softly, like with a very soft hand, or if you have deep skin tones, that is gorgeous. And then I have some, well, a ton of Becca, some Wet n Wild, there's some Tarte in the back, Laura Geller. These little Tarte ones were from a limited edition holiday set. And then on the very right, I have all of my Clinique Cheek Pops, which I love and adore so much. I think I have all of them except for one. And then some from the Balm, and yeah, another total assortment. I love this drawer. It's like so gratifying. It's just so even and pretty. So the next drawer is all eye products. So in the front, I have a ton of pigments, any type of loose pigment I keep in this little area. So there's some Jessie's Girl, Napoleon Purtis, Eye Candy. Eye Candy does really good like pigments and glitters. I get them at Eye Mats. There's some Violet Voss. I have some of the NYX Roll-On Shimmers. On the bottom, there's a ton of Makeup Geek. You can't really see them because they're all covered up with other things. What else is in there? Beauty Bar Baby. In the back, I have mascaras. And these are all good. I've decluttered them. They're just extras or backups, things like that. So some Tarte, L'Oreal, Girlactic. I like to have backup mascaras. What can I say? Then I have brow products. So there's some ColourPop in there, some of the Benefit brow products that they came out with. Next drawer is all like eye crayons. So there's the Rimmel Scandal Eyes, all of my NYX. Oh, what are the NYX ones called? Those eye crayons. Everybody went crazy for the milk one, the one in the shade Milk. And then some of the Clinique eye crayons. There's some loose, like an old, super old NYC ones in there. And then in the back, I have ColourPop and Tarte gel liners, which I don't really grab for, but I like to have them on hand. And then in the front here, I have a bunch of Wet n Wild palettes and quads and trios. I like old Wet n Wild eyeshadows. I feel like their old eyeshadows are so much better than the new ones. But yeah, they go deep. This is probably like 8 deep. Yeah, so I was just showing you. We're stacked. We're stacked like a mofo. And that's it for that drawer. Next drawer is all palettes, mostly blush and contour palettes. So I have my big NARS Laguna, the Too Faced Contour Kit. The It Cosmetics You Sculpted is really good. I like that one a lot. The Narcissist one from NARS, the Love Flush from Too Faced, Becca Jaclyn Hill, the limited edition Tarte ones from a few Christmases ago. The Becca Champagne Pop palette, which mine got stained. I don't know what got on it. The Gwen Stefani one from Urban Decay, this little Lorac one, which I really like. And the Je ne sais quoi one from It Cosmetics is also really good. Again, let's watch Nicole struggle trying to open this. Oh my goodness, really? Yeah. You should have heard me. I was probably cursing and getting really, really angry. But I managed to get it open. This one's really pretty. I know it looks so bright, but it actually is really nice. My favorite Marc Jacobs contour powder. Obviously, I'm in love. And then my ABH Glow Kits. I have 3 of them. And then I have the Moonchild one, which you guys have already seen. And then my little Tarte, This is like a double-sided blush palette. It is so cool. I love this thing. You could buy this and, oh Lord, and never need another blush in your life. Like, it has everything that you need in it. The Tartist Pro Glow I have back there. This drawer I grab into a ton. So I have products that I use like every day in this drawer. So the Tarte blush palette, and then I also have the Tarte highlighting palette back there. This Maybelline blush palette I freaking love. And the NYX Sweet Cheeks, they're both really, really good. I love both of them. And then in this little Tarte guy, Struggle Bus is happening again, I have Makeup Geek single blushes. And, oh, there's also a Smashbox blush palette, which is really, really nice. I love blush palettes and like highlighting palettes. I don't know why. Violet Voss highlighting palette, really good quality. So yeah, that's it for that drawer. I love this drawer. I could just swim in that drawer. Straighten it out, girl. There we go. Oh, not yet. Good job. So the next drawer is just a little bit of a cluster. So I have some eyeliners, which I have kind of split up into colors. So I have like all the blues together, all the greens together. Then I just got these NARS pot concealers, which I love, but I pulled my shades out and these are just the extra ones. And then in the back, I have all of my Jouer eyeshadow singles. So they just happen to fit perfectly into this box. They're probably stacked up like four layers, but I can't believe how perfectly they fit in this little cosmetics box. So I just keep them in there. And then I have highlighters that I use a ton. Like these are like my everyday highlighters. So I have my favorite Jouer ones, Laura Geller Gilded Honey, some of my favorite Ofra ones, and the Makeup Geek ones that I use a lot I have in here. And this gorgeous Dior one. Oh my gosh, you guys, look at this thing. It's so gorgeous. Oh, so pretty. I try not to use it because I don't want to mess it up, but I probably should just use it. My favorite Makeup Forever ones, some Wet n Wild. There's a little ColourPop one in the back there. Some more Ofra. Ofra's highlighters are where it's at. Oh, Kiko 208, amazing. Some more Laura Geller. So these are just like my everyday, my most favorite highlighters. I just keep them in this drawer. I still have some more organizing to do. And then those are Jouer liquid eyeliners that I don't think you can get anymore. So I know that drawer is a little mixture, but it works. Then this next drawer is all palettes. These are ones that I don't grab for very often. So Power of Makeup, wasn't the biggest fan of. Beauty Killer from Jeffree Star, not the biggest fan. The Pure Love Your Selfie, I have both of their palettes, which they're nice. I don't know. I don't grab for them that often. And then there are the L'Oreal La Palette 1 and La Palette 2, which these are really nice drugstore palettes. If you're on a serious budget, they are good. And then the limited edition Saucebox and Battle Lash palette, which is really cool. I'm really happy that I got that. And then there's just some Tarte. There's a big old Tarte palette in the back there. I have some Illamasqua quads. And the Smashbox cover shots, I didn't love these. I was so shocked. I mean, they're decent, but they just didn't wow me. So I keep them in there because I just don't grab for them. And then the Revealed palettes from Coastal Scents, which also are really nice quality and they're very inexpensive. Some of the NYX Avant Pop palettes, which are good. Makeup Revolution, there's a few Smashbox. This is more of a brow palette. It's like a eyebrow kind of palette. So I just keep that in there with the rest of my palettes. There's Makeup Revolution. And yeah, that be that, yo. Next drawer is eyeshadows. I love this drawer. So this little acrylic organizer, I have to figure out where it's from. I'll put it down below. But I have my L'Oreal Infallible singles. I have some Butter London singles, Napoleon Purtis, some of the Makeup Forever Star Powders, all of my NYX Prismatics, which I love the NYX Prismatic Shadows. They're amazing. A bunch of NARS singles, and then some Stila. There's some MAC on the right side. And then the other side of this drawer is backup products. So some of my favorite products that I know I'm going to go through, like my Tarte Friction Stick, the Wet n Wild Gold Bar, my favorite MAC Peach Duo that was limited edition, L'Oreal Brow product, and then, of course, my favorite CoverGirl BB cream, which I would die without, a backup of Jiffy from ColourPop, which is my favorite ultra satin, backup of Roller Lash, so just products that I love and I know I'm going to go through. NARS Recusion, I actually have like two backups of my lip facial from Tarte, which I love. And of course, you guys know I have two backups of my crystal powder, my ride or die powder. I would cut a bitch if they even thought about touching my crystal powder. Makeup Geek Corrupt. Yeah, another Wet n Wild highlighter. Oh, and I still have one backup of Oh Darling from MAC, which I will never part with. So that is that drawer. I know, again, it's like a weird one side's eyeshadows, one side backups, but it works. And then in here, these are lip products. So the NARS Velvet Lip Glides, I grabbed a few out of there that I liked, and the rest I just keep in here. The Vice Liquid Lips from Urban Decay, I just did not love these. So sad to say, but I just didn't love them. And then in the back, I have a bunch of setting sprays, just backup setting sprays, my Skindinavia, some Urban Decay, Fix Plus. And then I have the new Makeup Forever Acrylips, which I still need to test out, and then a bunch of just extra lip glosses. Marc Jacobs, Revlon, NYC, Cargo, YSL. Yeah. I know the way I organize some things is kind of weird, but I know where everything is at. Trust and believe that. And that little gold, like, sunglass box, that's actually Jouer brushes. It was a little limited edition set. And then this next drawer is, again, lip products. A ton, a crap ton of lip glosses. Just extra ones that I don't use that often. There's some Glossier in there, CoverGirl, just everything. Every dang thing. And then on the right side, I have to figure out also where that organizer's from. Oh, and this little guy, I've tried to get rid of this like 5 times, the Bite Beauty watercolor set, but every time I go to give it away, I'm like, I might need it. It's just different colored lip glosses. They're probably bad by now, and I should just throw it away, but I'm not going to. I'm going to keep it. I don't know why, but I'm going to keep it. This organizer, I have to figure out where that's from. I'll put it down below. In the front, I just have some lip palettes. So L'Oreal, Natasha Denona, and then a total assortment of lipsticks that I don't grab for on a daily basis. So there's some CoverGirl in there, Tarte, Rimmel, Gerard, Makeup Academy, L'Oreal, NYX Butter Glosses, all of my NARS Audacious I keep in there. And not because I don't use them a ton, just because, like, it's the perfect way to kind of organize them. Like, they just, I don't know, I like to have them all just, like, together. And anyway, there's some Makeup Forever, Marc Jacobs, those are all of my NYX Wicked, my Audacious, of course. So, yeah. Those is my lip products, yo. So that is going to do it for today, you guys. Part 2 of this video, we're going to go through my entire everyday makeup collection, my other Alex drawers, this little bookcase, which houses a ton of makeup. I actually really love this bookcase. It makes me so happy. Look at all those lippies. And we're also going to go through my little IKEA shelves, which I have a lot of lip products going on over here. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you guys next time. Mwah. Bye!
Oh my god! Come here! My bedroom! Oh my god, are you freaking kidding me? Move!
Move, bitch! Get out the way, bitch!
Really? Thanks a lot for focusing. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. Look at this glare! No! Okay, let's turn the ring light on and make some magic! Woo! You ready? You ready, bitch? Aw, look at looking now! Aw, you weren't supposed to see those Doritos! Shit! Oh my god, I just went to my P.O. box. Look at this! Oh, it's a pillow! I'm dying. I've died and gone to heaven. Oh, my gosh! Catch me outside, how about that? you guys want to see my three favorite pairs of sneakers right now? My Adidas. Wait, let me turn them. Oh, why is that just a random eyeshadow? Yo, that's ghetto AF, but look at these. You're dead, right? Oh my god. These are so cute. Love those. These are Adidas. They're so freaking cute. And my babies. My Space Jams. Oh my god, I have a sneaker addiction. These are so cute. Like, it hurts my body. The amount of cuteness. Yo, my street cred is through the roof. Oh my god, get in there! Like, why can I not open anything? Say hi, Mom.
Why are you recording me?
Because you're going to say hi to my YouTube family.
Hi, family.
This is what our Saturday night consists of.
Follow me on Instagram and
You fucking bitch!